Hi there, I'm Hassan. I'm the CEO and co-founder of REFSIX. I'm here at Whitehawk FC's enclosed ground to give you a quick demo of the REFSIX app in action. First, what you're going to do is open up the mobile phone. You'll see, the main thing you'll see on this screen is a big add a fixture button. So what we're going to do is add a game really quickly. In here, in the screen, you'll see a variety of different options about a game. You can put in the competition. You can put in the two teams that are playing. You can select the color of what teams are playing in, the venue, the date and time of the game, the number of players allowed on the starting team, as well as the number of subs allowed, which position you are as an official. Are you the referee, assistant, or fourth official? If you'd like to record goal scorers or not, and if the game has extra time, penalties, or it's just a normal game. And then you're able to select and set the half length and half time interval too. So once you've created that, you'll see that fixture stays in your app until the day of the game. When you get to the game, what you're going to do is click on the fixture and you'll see two other options here. Basically, here is where you're going to add in the team sheets, the players that are playing on the day. So what I'm going to do is add the home team, and in here you'll see a blank team sheet with numbers already preset. And you have a variety of options here. You can go in and just edit the numbers. If they're not 1 to 11, you can change that. You can go in and put the initials of the players or even the full name if you'd like. Once that's done, you save the team, do it for the away team as well, and then you're a few steps away from getting it on your watch. The first thing you're going to do after you've added the team sheets is click send and receive from watch. What's that doing is just pairing and making sure there's a connection with your watch. And then you're just going to click the send to watch button and you'll see the game appear instantly on the watch. Now you just leave the phone in the changing rooms and you're ready to go for the game. When you walk out with the players onto the pitch, you're obviously going to do the toss to see which team's kicking off and which side's going to be facing which end. And the first thing you're going to do on the watch is select which team is kicking off. That's so we know in the second half who to show is kicking off for the second half. When you're ready to blow the whistle, you simply tap on the tick and now the game's started. There's a variety of different timer options that you can go into. You can have a count up, count down, you can have a continuous timer, and an additional timer on the watch. So you can set it up exactly how you like. If there's an injury or a stoppage in play that you'd like to stop the clock for, you just simply tap on the watch and we'll start recording that additional time for you. As soon as that stoppage in play is finished, tap on the watch again and we know exactly how long has been stopped in play, and we'll tell you that when it gets to the end of the half. Now we're going to show you very simply how to do administration on the watch. The home team is to the left and the away team is to the right. So all I'm going to do for a home team yellow card is swipe from left to right and I'll see a menu for yellow card, red card, goals and subs. I can quickly tap on the yellow card and then I have the player list of all those players that I've put in. We have the starting 11 and then followed by the bench, so you can give a yellow card to any of the players that are allowed to be given a caution to. Simply tap on the player and then you'll get all the reason codes for why you could give a caution. Simply tap on the one you'd like to give and that's recorded the player, the yellow card and the caution code too, as well as the time. And that's really as easy as the administration is. You can do the same thing for red card. For goals, depending on what you selected, if you wanted goal scorers or not, you can simply click yes and you'll see the match screen update on the main timer. If you selected goal scorer, you'll see the list of the players that could have been selected as a goal scorer. And then for substitute, you just tap on substitute, you'll see the starting 11 first, you pick the player who's coming off, and then you'll see the bench and pick the player who's coming on. That's all of the administration features on the app on the watch that you'll need during the game. At the end of the half, simply hold down your finger on the watch and click end half. Now you'll see a halftime interval timer. So this is basically saying, okay, you've got 15 minutes of halftime and we're gonna let you know when that 15 minutes is up. So it's a pretty simple timer that gives you that peace of mind during that interval. When you're walking back out onto the pitch, you're gonna wanna hold down the screen again and end the halftime interval. And you'll see a screen that shows who's kicking off next and that tick again. When you're ready to blow the whistle for the second half, simply tap on the tick and you're good to go again. Again, really simply, you can go left and right to add any administration during the second half. I'm going to add a goal and a yellow card for another player. The beauty with our app is we know all the players who've been given a caution to. So if there is a second yellow card for any player, you simply tap on the yellow card again. In the list, you'll be able to see a Y next to the name of the player who's already been cautioned. So that gives you a sense that, okay, this is going to be a second yellow. So I'm going to tap that player, give him another caution, and then we'll definitely confirm to show you that actually it's a second yellow, you need to send the player off. And we'll ask you to confirm that just to make sure you've not made a mistake in law. I'm going to end the game now on the watch and show you what we see on the phone afterwards. So I'm back in the changing room now. I'm going to open up the app, and what I'll see in that fixture is the ability to retrieve from watch. I'm going to just tap that, and within a few seconds, all the data from my watch is now on my phone. I can quickly see in a team sheet view all of the players that have had an incident associated with them. I can click on the match screen, the match view, to see the chronological order of all the different things that have happened in the game. And then the beauty of our watch is in the background, we're recording a load of performance data about you as a referee. And we show you that here. We show you how far you've run and covered in distance, first half and second half. We show you a graph of every 5 minutes, how far you're covering. You can see a quick heat map of your positioning on the pitch. And you can show first half and second half. We then show you positioning of your cards on the pitch, as well as of that distance that you covered, how far was walking, how far was jogging, how far was running, and how far was sprinting. That's the app on a match day. The app also has a whole history of all the games that you've ever used REFSIX for. You can see every game and tap on it and get all the stats for those games in an instant. By clicking on the statistics screen, we then do a load of work for you where we show you the number of matches you've done, the total amount of yellow and red cards you've given, as well as the averages. We're going to build this out even further to show you timing of cards, distribution of cards based on caution code, and other things as we go. That's the REFSIX app. It's available on Apple Watch with iPhone and Android Wear with Android devices. And you can find out more at refsix.com.